Huh? What? Oh, I thought our bro nigga said something. And then, oh. Hoes in this house. There's some hoes in this house. There's some. Here, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I really hope you guys enjoy this video. Today I was showing you guys my tips and tricks that I do to get a bomb passport slash ID picture. So without further ado, let's just jump right into this video. I know y'all tired of looking at this background, and so am I, but my foundation, and I'm gonna go over the top of the brows. But since I have y'all know I got my scar right here, it's not as bad as it was when I first got it, but I definitely gave myself a scar when I popped my freaking pimple. So what I do is I put some of the leftover concealer on my hand and I just put it right over that scar. And I just dab it like that. Like, I don't really rub it into the skin, I don't blend it in 100%. The picture is gonna be in black and white, so I mean, you don't really have to do like eyeshadow looks because you can't see it anyway. Alicia, that's about to just be my stage name. I mean, shoot. out my nose and also my cheekbones. Sharpen up my jawline. You trying to cut a bee. Literally, you want your jawline to be so sharp, you cut somebody. Because you do not want that double chin poking out in these faces, I'm telling you. And now while that's setting for a few minutes, I'm gonna go back in and I'm gonna fix my eyebrow. Doing your eyebrow, like redoing your eyebrows all together, I guess you could add the powder first on your brows and then start putting on the pomade or the pencil and then, you know, cleaning them up with concealer. But I've just always done that. Like, I did my brows, put some powder, and then I just clean up my brows. I don't know why, but it's just something I've always done. That's just what works for me. Just do what works for you, whatever's easier for you guys. And so this is what a typical background will look like. Well, this is what a background will look like for when you take your pictures. You'll probably be about this tall. They'll show at least like right here. And yeah, it's just all white. So I definitely do not recommend you wear like a high bun or anything high where you can't see it. So if I was to wear a high bun, you wouldn't see that. For the sake of mine, I prefer to have a lot of hair in the picture because, I don't know, I like how it looks when I have all of my hair in the picture. I don't really want any cut off hair to look weird to me. So what I do is, I'm gonna play with my hair until it gets bigger. Personally, I recommend you looking in some sort of mirror before you take your pictures. My person was nice and she let me run to the bathroom really quickly before I took my picture. Oh no, I guess that's just a once in a blue moon type thing. But if you have your phone, just look at your phone. Make sure you look good. Make sure you don't have any, you know, boogies or anything. Make sure if you need to add a little bit of lip gloss, add some lip gloss. So, yeah. I've seen this TikTok where it said to find your inner model face. What you do is, you smile, you raise your eyebrows, and then you, like, look, make a straight face. This is bothering me. Hold on. So. Alright, let me see. Now, when you're taking your pictures, I recommend you do like the little, like the lip pucker a little bit. So like, or whatever it's called when you open your, like your bottom lip drop. So like, cause you have to be straight. But, all right, so if you was to have a high hairstyle, you would literally have no hair. It would be like this. This is how I took my first ever ID picture. I wore a bun. I didn't have any makeup on. I looked disgusting. And I was like this. Dead at the camera, just like that. I don't recommend that at all. That's why I say it's best to wear your hair down, whether you're wearing braids or your natural hair. I say wear it down where it can be seen and you don't look bald. Unless you actually are bald. I don't know. I just recommend having some hair in the frame. When you're taking your passport/ID picture, you really want to make sure you have some lip gloss on. Like, and also you want to make sure there's no flashback in your makeup. So what I do is I recommend you taking a picture with the back camera and making sure you have no flashback at all. But definitely setting your face and spraying your face, it makes all the powder like sink into your skin like it should, so you won't have flashback at all. Practice that, and when you go to take your ID pictures, sweetie, you're gonna slay those pictures. Those pictures are gonna come out so mother effing bomb, it's not even funny. So, peace out. Thank you for watching. I really hope you guys enjoy. Bye.